need to keep in mind too, we didn't invent slavery, we ended it. It was a really hard thing to do. I mean, we fought a civil war over it. England ended slavery just before that, but slavery existed everywhere throughout all of humanity. I mean, my ancestors are Irish. They were enslaved by the British to the tune of 1.25 million. People need God. That's what it comes down to.
Okay, so there's obviously a lot there that we can dive into. What you know what I love though? I love
that
the
he looks
use
like
of-
an irradiated Kieran Culkin.
No, this isn't about this guy. I don't know who that guy is. I don't really care who that guy is. I care that a lot of Trumpers believe what he believes, but yes, he kind of does. And I do miss Succession. Anyway, I love the use of the word we. We ended it. Who the hell's we in that? First of all, it's not you and it's not me. We weren't alive then. But there were very much a lot of people in America who were not actively we trying to get rid of slavery. They were trying to continue it, actually. Could we maybe identify who those people and forces actually were? And I love the skip from we didn't invent it, we ended it. Okay, but we also did it. We did slavery for hundreds of years, many, many people, unimaginable horrific acts. What you like skipped over as if it was just an ellipses or whatever is unimaginable human suffering that you would love for us to gloss over in our education system and in our understanding that can inform politics in the same way that you glossed over it in that statement.
Like he is, in my opinion, Kyrie Irving. Like and the heart of who my garbage person is, because it's not today, because it's not exactly Kyrie Irving. Okay. I'll give a little hint. It's somebody who's not smart who pretends that they are. Mm-hmm. And that's it. Like the smirk, the self-satisfied, like this guy very obviously thinks he is the wisest person in the universe because he saw like one tweet about something or one Facebook post or somebody said something and he admires that person. So he just co-opted a talking point.
Yes.
That's it. And you know how I feel, yourself included, when people put a t-shirt on under a blazer. Like,
first of all,
look, bro,
there's a reason.
Or go and finish off your audition for the reboot of Miami Vice, because that is roll it up, buddy, roll it up.
Anyway, there's a reason. I'm not gonna debate that right now. I do agree though. It's wanting to be intelligent, but not wanting to become intelligent or curious or like it's just parroting talking points, and like copying a copy, you lose little bits and pieces every time that's like sent from one generation to the next.
It's someone telling you what, like learn your history, but they don't know it.
Yeah.
Like that's the thing about like the Kyrie, like all the people who were like, listen, I don't wanna look too deep into the history of what happened to the Jews, because who could be expected to like do deep dives into ancient texts like from the History Channel? And then they're like, anyway, so if you look deep into Deuteronomy, verse 1855, like it's like no. And also that's all been debunked. Like we know the history. That's why we're like all these things like the Joe Rogans and everybody, the Elon Musks who were like, have you heard this cool new argument? I have heard that argument. It is neither cool nor new. And you pretend to be this super smart person, but the reason that we have these discussions and have had these discussions is because of the bad things that happen when we don't. But when you show up to like to the town square, as you want to call it, trying to advance a conversation, when really the conversation is literally 100, maybe 1,000 years beyond that. I can't really respect your opinion if you come with stupid stuff like we ended slavery. He's saying the Republicans, people who became Republican, left the Democratic Party. They left for the Democratic Party to start the KKK because the slaves were freed. And then they left the Democratic Party to become the Republicans because the Democrats were for civil rights. Like they don't know the history. At the same time, saying learn your history.
Yes, there should be a quest for knowledge, and at the very least, a quest to understand to what extent you possess knowledge. You should not enter, like, believing that when you learn something, you're like the third person to ever learn it in history is insanity. You might be ignorant, and getting rid of your ignorance is difficult, but at least be knowledgeable of what you're ignorant of. Understand your limitations. That's a form of intellectual humility that I think is far too rare in the modern era. Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.